Welcome to AlphaNumeric Tricks. In last video, we have seen that the properties of Z transform. And now we are going to see first shifting theorem and the second shifting theorem in Z transform. Okay, now we will start the theorem. First shifting theorem. If Z transform of f of t is equal to f of z, then Z transform of e power minus a t f of t is equal to Z transform of z into e power minus e power a into capital T. Here minus is there. In your result, you have plus e power a into capital T. The definition of Z transform of f of n is summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n Z power minus n, isn't it? But it is in the function is in terms of n. But here the function is in terms of time domain. It is given in terms of t. So in that case, you have to replace this t is equal to nt. Okay, you have to replace small t is equal to n into capital T. Okay, and then your definition becomes is the transform of f of t is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of nt. T is replaced by n into here, and this t is replaced by n into capital T Z power minus n, this and all the same. Okay, and then you have to take this to be here we have in the function it is given to be e power minus a t f of t. We have to find out Z transform of this function. Okay, so Z transform of e power minus a t f of t is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity. Here in the place of f of t, you have e power minus a t into f of t. You write that e power minus a into t is replaced by n into capital T. You have to write like this f of n t n into capital T is it power minus n. Okay, so here you have to take this to be, that is you have to combine the terms. Okay, summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n t into here is it e power minus a t, you can combine, isn't it? Here you have minus a and z power a is there. Here a is there and t, you can take this, n is common, so take it outside n. Or you can write this to be summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n t into, because in our z transform formula we need a minus, isn't it? So is it transform of here you have z into this term, you have to write it. You are combining this Z. Okay. So, not Z transform, Z into. Z e power a t whole power minus n. So, this in the place of a e power f, that is in the place of Z power n, you have Z e power a t is there. So, you can write this to be f of Z e power a into capital T. So, Z transform of e power minus a t f of t is equal to f of z e power a t. This is your first shifting theorem. You have to remember this. When doing problems, we can use this. So, you have to remember this theorem. Okay, next we will see second shifting theorem. Second shifting theorem is if z transform of f of t is equal to f of z, then is the transform of f of t plus capital T is equal to small z into, this is not a z transform, this is small z into f of z minus f at 0. This result we have to prove that R, this is the same as is the transform of f of n plus 1. Instead of t, you have n plus 1, that's it. F of n, you have n plus 1 is also given. In that case, you have to take z into f of z minus z into f at 0. Okay, I'll prove this one in terms of t, and you do this. This is similar to the previous case. You can do it. I'll do this one in t plus t we do now. Okay, so z transform of f of t plus t we have to write it. Okay, this is a transform definition. You have to write it here. Summation n is equal to 0 to infinity. We are using the definition for z transform here. In the place of f of t, you have f of t plus t is there. So, you have to write f of n t plus t. You can write this to be f of n t plus t. Z power, z ravi a minus n, you have to use it, isn't it? So, here summation n is equal to 0 to infinity. You can write this to be f of n plus 1. You can take into t, you can write it, isn't it? F of n plus 1, you can take it into t, is it power minus n, is it power minus n you have. Okay, so from this we have but n is equal to 0 to infinity we have, but here when you substitute n is equal to f of 0 should be there in our problem. And when you here in this definition, when you substituting here, summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n is it power minus n, you are substituting n is equal to 0, this becomes f of 0 is it power 0 1 plus n is equal to 1, you are substituting f of 1 is it power minus 1, like that it will go. But here n is when you substituting n is equal to 0, f of t itself it goes, isn't it? So we can change the limit. Suppose we take it to be this n plus 1. This n plus 1 is equal to some m. Okay. And when n is equal to 0, when you're substituting n is equal to 0 here, your limit m is equal to 1. And n is equal to infinity here, your m is equal to infinity. So, according to this substitution, your limits becomes m is equal to 0, that is 1 to infinity. Not 0, 1, m is equal to, n is equal to 0, m is equal to 1. So, 1 to infinity, f of here, n plus 1 is replaced by m into t, is it power, this n is replaced by, from this, n is replaced by m minus 1. Okay, so m minus 1, minus of, this n is replaced by m minus 1. Okay, so which is equal to summation m is equal to 1 to infinity f of m t into z power, here m is from minus 1, isn't it? So z power minus m into z, you can write it, isn't it? So z can be taken to outside, z into here you have, when you're taking minus of minus, it becomes plus z power 1. It is independent from the limit, so you can take it outside. That's why m is equal to 1 to infinity f of m t into z power minus m. So this is the term we have, but here this is your when you're taking this z transform of, that is z transform of n t, what is z transform of f of n t formula, that is equal to summation n is equal to, this is your result now, r n t, and you can write this to be z transform of f of t also, you can take is a transform of f of t is equal to, this is your desired definition, summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n into capital T is it power minus n, isn't it? So here n is equal to 0 to infinity is a per change of variable will not affect the value of the z transform. So there is nothing wrong in this. When you're using this instead of n, you can use m, nothing wrong in that. But here your limit starting from 0 to infinity, but here 1 to infinity. So f of 0 is missing here. Okay, f of 0 is missing, n is equal to 0. So you can write this to be z into, this term can be written as this term, you can write this term as z transform of, or you can write this way also, summation m is equal to 0 to infinity, when you adding 0 here, f of m t into z power minus m, okay, minus, when you substituting f is equal to 0, f is m is equal to 0, what happened, is it power 0, it becomes 1, isn't it? So we are taking that to be, yeah, but here you have m is equal to 0, f of 0 you have, okay? So meaning here we are adding and subtracting 1 f of 0, and this 1 f of 0 was included in this limit, and another f of 0 is here, okay? And you can write this to be z into, what is this term, is it transform of f of t, or you can write this to be f of z, Okay, this term is f of z minus f at 0. This is the second shifting theorem. That is a transform of f of t plus t is equal to z into f of z minus f of 0. This z is common for both the terms. It is not z transform, it is a small z. That is an element, single term this z is. Okay, z into f of z minus f at 0. This is the second shifting theorem. And one more problem similar to this we will do. This is not a theorem, but it is under properties it will come. Okay, this problem, this comes under the property. That is, prove that you have to prove this result. Is it transform of f of n plus k is equal to z power k into f of z minus f of 0 minus f of 1 by z minus etc. You can have. Okay, so we have to write the definition for is a transform of f of n plus k. We have to write it. Is a transform of f of n plus k is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n plus k into z power minus n. Isn't it? So here we have here n plus k is there, so here also we have to make this n plus k. So summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n plus k z power minus n. Here you have z power minus n into here we have to add and subtract 1k without changing this value. We are adding and subtracting 1k. Okay, so which is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n plus k into, we are combining this term, these two terms here, mind taking minus outside, z power n plus k into 1 z power k is there, we take that to outside. Okay, outside of this summation. So z power k summation n is equal to 0 to infinity f of n plus k into z power minus of n plus k you have. Okay, and then suppose you are substituting this value. Suppose your n plus k is equal to, as usual, n plus k is equal to some m. When n is equal to 0, k is equal to m. Okay, m is equal to, we are writing the limit for m. K is equal to m. That way also you can write it, but you write this way. N is equal to 0 and your limit m is equal to k. We need the limits for m, no? So you write this way. When n is equal to infinity, when you substitute infinity plus k is again infinity. So m is equal to infinity. So which is equal to z power k into summation. And when you substituting your n varies from 0 to infinity, your m varies from k to infinity. That is the limit you have to substitute here. M is equal to k to infinity f of n plus k is replaced by m z power minus m. Okay, so you can write this to be z transform of the function f of m or f of n, you can write it, but only thing is z transform start from 0 to infinity, isn't it? 0 to infinity. So how many terms are missing here? F of k, only when you're expanding this you get f of k z power minus k plus f of k plus 1 z power minus of k plus 1, like that only it is expanded. But here how many terms are missing? There up to k minus 1 terms are missing. 0 to k minus 1 terms are missing here, isn't it? So you can write this to be z power k into, here you can write this term. This term is missing. Summation m is equal to 0 to k minus 1 f of m z power minus m. Okay, this term is missing. And plus summation m is equal to k to infinity, we add and subtract up to this terms. Okay, m is equal to k to infinity f of m z power minus m. Okay, minus this term we have to subtract. Summation k is equal to 0 to m is equal to 0 to k minus 1, we have to subtract. Summation m is equal to 0 to k minus 1 f of m z power minus m. We have to add and subtract this term without changing this expansion, because 0 to k minus 1 terms are missing here. So we adding this term and subtracting this term without changing this summation. Okay, so which is equal to z power k into, we can write this term to be up to 0 to k minus 1 is there and k to infinity is there. So combining this, you can write this to be m is equal to 0 to infinity f of m z power minus m. Okay, this is one term, minus summation k is equal to m is equal to 0 to k minus 1 f of m z power minus m. This is there. And you can write this to be z power k into, this term can be written as f of z, isn't it? F of z minus, when you're substituting k is equal to 0, minus of this term you have. When you're substituting this term, fkm is equal to 0, f of 0 into z power 0 is 1. Plus, when you're substituting, minus is taken outside. Okay, that's why you have plus. M is equal to 1 when you're substituting, f of 1 into z power minus 1. Plus, when you're substituting, m is equal to 2, f of 2 into z power minus 2. Plus, etc. Plus, how many terms up to k minus 1 we have to substitute? F of k minus 1 into z power minus of k minus 1. Or you can have this z power k into f of z minus f at 0 minus f of 1 by z. Like that you can write it. F of 1 by z minus f of 2 by z squared plus x, minus etc. Because we are taking minus inside. Etc. minus f of k minus 1 divided by z power k minus 1. This is the result we have to prove. That is, z transform of f of n plus k is equal to, this is the result we have to prove. Okay. That's all for this video. If you have any doubts, please provide in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Thank you.